All right, this is in response to Phil DeFranco's video on the underwear bomber. Basically, this guy strapped on a bomb, put it in his underwear. He tried to go to Detroit's airport. He actually made it through there. He got on the airplane, tried to set it off. Some passengers took him down, and Phil DeFranco was asking, basically, is this really necessary, the type of airport security that we have? Do we really need this type of security? After all, the guy did basically get right through the system, and Phil DeFranco mentioned something that got me thinking. He said that if somebody really wanted to do some damage, they can stand in line, in a check-in line, and set up for a bomb right there, and they can kill a lot of people that way. And, you know, now that I think about it, to really expand upon that, if somebody really wanted to kill a bunch of people, they can work with a partner. One person can set off a bomb at the check-in area or where they do the luggage or where they basically frisk people and they send people through the machines and whatever. And as people run away from that area, there could be another guy waiting by the nearby exit and he can set off a bomb to get the people who are running away from the original bomb. So that can be a dual strike type of attack right there. I mean, what I'm trying to say is there's no real way to make airports 100% secure. You know, I think you just have to really use common sense. The best way to really protect people at the airports is to have intelligent people working there who have a lot of experience in dealing with people and dealing with security threats. Because there's no magic machine that's going to be able to prevent all explosives and all types of threats from getting onto the plane. You know, somebody may decide to attack a plane by simply focusing on getting into the cockpit and basically get in there and killing the pilot or something and causing a serious malfunction with the system, and that can actually crash a plane. I mean, there's a lot of ways you can bring a plane down, so I think that really you have to start with personnel. That's really the key. You know, ultimately, I think if we want to keep ourselves safer, we have to implement a foreign policy that is based on protecting the best interests of the American people and not the military-industrial complex. I think our foreign policy, the fact that we're getting people killed overseas, that's more likely to make people angry at us and want to hurt us. I think it just comes down to common sense. If you're using predator droids to go into countries and dropping bombs and killing innocent people, you know, there's going to be consequences for that. And yes, I do think legitimate, real attacks could happen. But that doesn't mean that false flag attacks couldn't happen. You could have a combination of both. You know, just because someone believes that U.S. foreign policy could increase the likelihood of other people attacking us doesn't mean that they believe that every single attack is a result of an outside threat. So just want to clear that up. Interesting thing is there's this attorney who basically said that he was on the plane, well, he was on the plane, and he saw the suspect get escorted through security. He didn't even need a passport, and he got onto the airplane. This is very, very suspicious stuff. This whole story starts to stink to me when you really, really read about what's going on here. I don't know what is going on here. You know, when it comes down to it, if I had to choose between having absolutely no freedom, but being 100% safe from external threats, and living in a country where I had a lot more freedom, but was more vulnerable to an external threat, I would rather die in a terrorist attack than live like a prisoner. And that's just me. I don't know how you guys think. You guys know I'm a libertarian. Maybe you guys feel differently, but tell me, what do you think? Which society would you rather live in? I guess I'll end this video with one of my favorite quotes. He who sacrifices his freedom for security deserves neither. Anyway, thank you for watching my video. Have a good day. Bye. Yeah, now this is what Michigan looks like.